Hello, you wonderful people. So for those of you who don't know, I kind of do this thing on my channel called Hero or Villain. Basically, it's ultimately kind of what inspired this video. I mean, really, I wanted to do this video a while back, just never took the time to sit down and record it. But nevertheless, I'm doing it now. Basically, this video is Hero or Villain for you. What I mean is, ultimately, on the scale of hero or villain, where would you fall? Obviously, I'm meaning this in a very fictitious sense. This is just meant to be fun and stupid nerdiness, like 99% of what pops up on this channel. So, I mean, obviously, like, there's pros and cons to everything, because I think ultimately, when you break it down, I think 95% of people want to be heroes. Like, there are the 5% that just want to be like, I'm fine with being a villain, which is give and take, because obviously as a hero, it's like, oh man, it's like you're doing good, you're fighting for justice. I mean, I'm sure for other people, they have like a more selfish reason for wanting to be a hero, because it's like, oh, I get to be famous. Literally, Booster Gold is a great example of that. He wanted to be a hero just for the fame, but eventually it came like, hey, I'll be a hero just to be a hero, you know, to help people, you know, to do the right thing. I mean, the sad thing is a lot of stories are written to a point where it's like, not everyone can be a hero. Just like, it's actually, when you actually break things down and think about it, it's like, no, like some stories are written so like, this person was meant to be a villain. It's just like, either look at their design or just their background. It's like everything was set up for this character to turn into a villain. I mean, but the whole thing is like being a hero has its problems, because obviously as a hero, it's kind of like, well, basically that means everyone that you love and care about is always in danger. So it's just like, oh wait, so you're gonna be with this person, whether or not you know this person is a hero. There's that whole complication of like, well, the fact is that means, you know, there's always gonna be villains or super villains coming after you, threatening your life. And then there's also the whole aspect of like, well, you can't be with this person too because it's selfish. It's actually kind of interesting because it kind of falls into Smallville, because that was kind of like a question that Lois kind of brought up at one point in time, because it's like, should I really, was it Lois or was it, I'm pretty sure it was Lois. It's like, why should I really be with Clark? Because it's like, he has this grand destiny. He's supposed to be this hero, and is being with me like stopping him from reaching his full potential as a hero? You know, so it turns into a question like that. It's like, you know, I'm keeping this person grounded and keeping them normal when they should be out there saving other people. Instead, you know, it turns into that whole situation, which it's kind of something, you know, you go back and forth on, because it's like, wait a minute, but heroes need that human connection too, because if you're just superhero all the time, I feel like eventually that's just going to burn you out, and you're just going to eventually kind of go rogue. You're just going to become numb to things. So it's just like, you stay superhero mode too long, and it's just like, well, eventually the lines might start getting a little blurry, and you might just end up crossing over into that villain lane. So, because it always seems like when it comes to superheroes, their love life always kind of comes second. It's that whole balancing of like, oh, like, you know, especially if you're at that point where it's like you're keeping your secret, you know, you're keeping your superhero identity a secret from the person you're with too. So you have to balance that a lot, like the whole Spider-Man and Mary Jane, or maybe, you know, Lois and Clark, which eventually at different points in time. I think for both cases, it's like their significant others end up finding out their secrets, but still there's that whole aspect of still there anyway. Whereas the villain side of things, it's like, one, you don't have to worry about that. Like, you never have to worry about any loved ones that you cared about being, well, I say that, but, you know, recent things popping up, like Crisis on Earth X, it's like, oh, you have, like, Earth X, Oliver, and Earth X, Kara being a couple, so it's like, even villains have love. But typically, it's like, they don't have anyone that they necessarily care about, that they're just kind of like, oh, yeah, nothing can stop me, I have no weaknesses, I can go full villainy. Also, villains don't restrain themselves, whereas a superhero might feel the need to, like, go all crazy with their powers because it means destroying the city or getting innocent people involved. Villains don't feel like that. It's like, oh, I have all these people I can use to kind of, like, use against you, and I don't care because I plan on destroying the city or destroying the world or whatever my villainous ambitions are. Villains can be villains 100% of the time. I don't know, like, do let me know, are there any villains that actually have, like, a day job like most superheroes do? Because I guess, like, one I could think of is, like, Lex Luthor. He, like, has a whole, like, day job of running a corporation and everything, but I guess that coincides with his whole evilness. And I guess Lex is one of those people, too, that's, like, in his own twisted way, he's trying to do the right thing. He wants to be the hero because it's kind of that situation of, like, it's that whole question of, like, oh, what, like I brought up earlier, if you're a hero, eventually, what's to stop you from slipping over to villainy? Like, Kryptonians in general, this applies to Superman and Supergirl. It's like, you literally have the powers of gods, and it's like, if you wanted to. And same thing could apply to Wonder Woman, too, because now that I know, like, she's a god. Like, I mean, to be fair, it applies to all superheroes who have super abilities. And not even just super abilities, even just regular, like, non-powered heroes like Batman as well could just as easily go from helping people to hurting people and being villains. I mean, as you can see with the whole multiverse situation in DC, that's already kind of proven. Like, they're like, oh yeah, there are evil versions of people. It's like, oh, just because you're good in this world doesn't mean on Earth X you're not a total piece of crap. It just, in my mind, I feel like it takes more effort to be a hero than it is to be a villain. Like I said, villains don't have to try. It's just like, oh, I have to be evil and nothing else. Okay, heroes, it's like, I have to be good. I have to make sure I don't cross the line, cross my own code, and have to protect people. And it's just, it's so interesting. Like, when you actually break it down and just like, I never really thought about that before till just now. Like, how easy it is to be a villain. But I guess that just makes the whole hero thing much more rewarding because you have to try. I mean, once again, nobody wants to be the villain. It's usually just circumstances that lead someone to go down that route. Because I really can't think of any villains that are just villains to be villains. I mean, maybe you get some galactic level bad guys like Thanos or Darkseid. That's kind of like, yeah, we just want to rule and crush everything. That's all we care about. So maybe, but even then, I don't know their backgrounds like that. So, well, I guess arguably you can say that about certain bad guys like Doomsday, as well as the introduction to Rain on the TV show Supergirl. Like, it seems like their main motive is just to destroy, at least in Doomsday's case. I'm still, obviously, I don't know much about Rain. This is like my first introduction to her in amongst the DC stuff. So, I mean, there might be more to her that kind of develops later on as this current season of Supergirl progresses. But Doomsday is like, nah, all I care about is destruction. I'm just born for destruction. I will destroy and kill everything. So, though, you know, Rain is also known as World Killer, so it seems like it might apply the same thing there, too. Especially because lately I've been, because, like, Doomsday and her seem very similar to me and just kind of almost like how they came to be and everything. Nevertheless, that's me going down another tangent. It's kind of, I mean, kind of ties in, but it's unimportant. Like, ultimately, my question to you is, as I brought at the beginning, where do you stand on the whole situation? Do you think you'd be a hero or a villain? Which would you prefer? Do you feel like you'd want to be a villain just because you feel like there'd be a lot more interesting aspects to your story? I mean, because some people might feel like, well, villains are probably more well-written than heroes. Or maybe some people like heroes are more well-written than villains. I mean, if you want to, go into your whole backstory if you want to, too, about how you became a hero or villain, or maybe come up with super names if you want to. I don't know. Maybe I'll make a part two to this video where I kind of do the same thing. I don't know. This video was just me rambling on, which, to be fair, is like every other video on this channel. Just let me know your thoughts about everything in the comments down below. But really, that's all I want to talk about in this video. Till the next time, meet, be happy, be safe, look like to the fullest, and enjoy it. Good day and goodbye.